Hi, my name is Steve and I'm an application engineer with Agilent Technologies. In this video I'll be talking about direct digital synthesis, which is one of the most popular technologies used in arbitrary waveform generators to synthesize signals. In my next video I'll be talking about how Agilent's new 33500 series function generator uses newer technology that overcomes many of the downsides of DDS.
Here's a block diagram showing the DDS circuitry. A stream of digital data representing the desired waveform is sequentially read from waveform memory and is applied to the input of a digital to analog converter. The DAC is clocked at the function generator sampling frequency and outputs a series of voltage steps approximating the desired waveform. A low-pass anti-aliasing filter then smooths the voltage steps to create the final waveform. The function generator represents amplitude values by a number of discrete voltage levels determined by the vertical resolution. The specified waveform data is divided into samples such that one waveform cycle exactly fills waveform memory. If you create an arbitrary waveform that does not contain exactly the number of points in waveform memory, the waveform is automatically stretched by repeating points or by interpolating between existing points as needed to fill the waveform memory. Since all of waveform memory is filled with one waveform cycle, each memory location corresponds to a phase angle of 2 pi divided by the number of points in waveform memory. DDS generators use a phase accumulation technique to control waveform memory addressing. Instead of using a counter to generate sequential memory addresses, an adder is used. On each clock cycle, the constant loaded into the phase increment register, or PIR, is added to the present result in the phase accumulator. The most significant bits of the phase accumulator output are used to address waveform memory. By changing the PIR constant, the number of clock cycles required to step through the entire waveform memory changes, thus changing the output frequency. When a new PIR constant is loaded into the register, the waveform output frequency changes phase continuously following the next clock cycle. The PIR determines how fast the phase value changes with time and ultimately controls the frequency being synthesized. More bits in the phase accumulator result in finer frequency resolution. When synthesizing low frequencies, the address will not change during every clock cycle. However, at high frequencies, the address will change by more than one location during each clock cycle, and some points will be skipped. If too many points are skipped, a phenomenon known as aliasing will occur, and the waveform output will become somewhat distorted. This is one of the major drawbacks of using DDS.